On this episode of Carpe Diem, we're talking eggs. Let's get cracking. Scrambled, boiled, or poached. Bon appetit. These Canadian eggs are good for your Zoomer health. Learn why with dietitian Patricia Chui and egg farmer Yushka.
Carpe Diem. Seizing the day for Canadians as we age.
Welcome to Carpe Diem. Did you know the World Health Organization has designated this, the humble egg, the world's most perfect food? On this episode, we talk about their farming, cooking, and nutritional value. But first, do you eat eggs?
Yes, I do.
Yes, we absolutely love eggs.
Yes, I do eat eggs.
Yes, I do. I eat eggs.
Now, do you know what kind of eggs to get? To buy?
Normally free range.
Well, I usually look for like a free range, you know, healthy type egg.
I buy large free range.
Yummy eggs.
And what kind of eggs do you like to buy?
Same.
Well, I just buy the eggs at the grocery store.
Free range?
Not necessarily.
Cage free? What do you like to buy?
Well, I just go by whatever has the most stock and the best date on them.
Pretty interesting. Yushka, Patricia, what's in an egg?
Well, they're a perfect source of protein. There's about 14 key vitamins and minerals. I like the street talker who said she likes the yummy eggs. They're yummy, they're versatile, they're good for you.
And Yushka, can you cut an egg open and let's talk about what's inside the egg?
Sure, I boiled these last night quickly, but Patricia can talk a little bit more about what's in
an egg. Yeah, sure thing. Well, the bulk of the protein in an egg is in the white, but a lot of the concentrated nutrients are in the yolk. So I'm a fan of eating the whole egg, and I'm also a fan of eating a balanced meal. So a balanced meal has half the plate as vegetables with some quality protein, which an egg certainly is, and your whole grains along with that.
Now I'm curious about that beautiful bright yellow yolk.
Mm-hmm.
They're not all like that.
No, a high corn-based diet will give you a much yellower yolk. Wheat gives you a little bit of a paler yolk. And in my barn, I have fussy hens who some want more corn in their diet and some want more wheat. They do have that choice.
And the feed can dictate the nutritional value. Beautiful. To a point. I mean, generally, eggs or eggs across the board, white, brown, have very similar nutrient profile, but a hen that's fed omega-3 in their feed, for example, flax seed, that would produce a higher level of omega-3 in the egg.
Okay, now that we have gotten to know our egg, let's meet the humble hen that puts them on our table at your farm.
We're out here on a gorgeous day in Chilliwack, British Columbia. The average Canadian will crack, boil, fry, perhaps even baste an egg over 250 times a year. And they're all sourced from local farmers.
Right now they're producing around 3,500 eggs, 3,600 eggs a day. I pick them by hand, so nothing automated there really. And they leave the farm once a week.
Well, we are the regulatory body. We regulate the 141 family-owned farms here in BC. We make sure they're following all the rules. The big ones are food safety and animal care.
The reason we're suiting up here is because I may have been somewhere where I shouldn't have been. I may have been on a farm. I may have a bird at home. And it's all for protection for these gals we have behind me over here.
So we're always going to knock when we walk into any barn that warns the girls that we're coming, and hopefully they won't panic when we open the door.
That's your secret knock?
That's my
You
secret
came up
knock.
With so that
I
secret
know,
three
I know.
Knocks?
It's pretty amazing, really.
I could come up with a secret. Four knocks is the way to go.
Hazel Spring Organics is a fantastic organic farm. Yushka has about 4,000 hens here. They're housed in this beautiful barn where they have access to fresh water all the time. They have a beautiful, nutritious organic feed. They have beautiful nest boxes where they prefer to go and lay their eggs. And then, as you can see, they have this range that they are out in anytime the weather is good.
In British Columbia alone, about 141 registered farmers have enough hens to produce 84 million of these dozen boxes of eggs. Dean Atwell, back to the studio.
Patricia, why are eggs important to have in a diet?
Well, they're a great source of protein. As I mentioned, they supply 14 key nutrients. A couple key ones for seniors, vitamin B12. An egg has 65% of what we need, and that's very healthy for our brains and our nervous system. There's iron in an egg. There's vitamin E, vitamin D, and vitamin D can be a tricky one to get enough of in our diet. We only get it for half the year, really, from the sun, so it's good to get it from eggs.
Right. When we come back, we'll demystify shopping for eggs.
Still ahead on Carpe Diem.
Free-run hens live in barns where they can run around wherever they like. And then we have free-range. They live in similar barns, but they do have access to the outdoors.
Carpe Diem, seizing the day for Canadians as we age.
The average Canadian eats 250 eggs a year. With so many varieties available, I really wanted to find out what egg carton to buy at the store. Leah went shopping for us.
You wanted to know how to shop for eggs? I am here at the local grocery store with Amanda from BC Egg. She is the expert. She's going to navigate us through. First, I want to know, how do you know so much about eggs yourself?
Well, I've had the pleasure of working at BC Egg for a few years now. I've been on a lot of farms and I met all the farmers, so I have learned on the job.
I gotta say, it's a little bit overwhelming. I go to the grocery store. I don't even know how many different kinds of eggs we have. So like cage-free, this one says cage-free. This one says free run. I don't know how many different types.
So yeah, we have lots of different types of eggs. These caged eggs, these ones happen to be omega-3, so they're enhanced with omega-3 fatty acids. Free run hens live in barns where they can run around wherever they like.
Okay.
And then we have free range. They live in similar barns, but they do have access to the outdoors.
Outside. If you keep a hen inside, they're only going to get the food that was brought in. But if they're outside, they can eat bugs and different seeds from the ground, that sort of thing.
You have to remember the farmers are feeding the hens a complete feed. It's designed to optimize their health.
Okay.
They do go outside and they have the opportunity to eat bugs and grass, but it doesn't add anything more to their diet nutritionally.
Right.
Just a little treat, you know.
Got it. So that one tastes different than the white eggs?
No, I think white eggs and brown eggs taste identical.
Oh, so you've done your own taste testing?
I've done extensive taste testing.
How are they priced?
Well, the retail stores themselves will set the pricing. Of course, it costs more to farm an organic egg as opposed to a regular egg, so those naturally will cost more.
Nutritional value, how do we weigh that out?
So with just your regular, normal eggs, they have about the same amount of nutrition. A large egg has 70 calories, 6 grams of protein, 9 essential amino acids. But then there are also hens that are fed a diet that is high in like vitamin D or omega-3 fatty acids, which are of course good for us.
Somebody comes into the store and they're going, I don't know what to buy. What's your best advice?
My best advice is to buy the egg that best fits your budget.
Okay.
All of them are equally nutritious and equally delicious.
I guess, Amanda, the only thing for us to do is to taste test all the eggs.
Absolutely, enjoy.
Back to you in the studio.
Yushka, with so many varieties, consumers really need to read the labels. Mm-hmm. And I guess one of the things to look for, too, is Canadian made.
Absolutely. We will have stamped on a carton that it's grown in Canada. And eggs are all about choices, so that's why we have so many different varieties as well.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan of choice for Canadians, and I like what Amanda said in terms of finding one that fits within your budget and your philosophy, bearing in mind that variety is a key principle of healthy eating. Maybe sometimes you try the organic, the free range. If you can't afford the organic all the time, don't feel like you're missing out on nutrients if you are buying the more affordable egg. Yeah.
So we actually asked you, what kind of eggs do you buy?
Organic, free range.
Okay, free range and organic. Why is that?
Uncaged.
Yes, uncaged. For the respect to the bird.
I don't know, I don't like to think of the chickens being treated badly. I kind of think it's important to think about where your stuff comes from.
So free range, huh? Mm-hmm.
Free range.
And what does that mean for the chickens?
It means that they're not caged. They're pretty much they're outdoors and doing their thing. And then it's a natural way of getting the eggs instead of being in farms.
Free range, organic, free run, conventional. These are words that consumers hear about eggs. And I have a question for you. Are there any differences between these varieties?
Yeah, there are differences in hen housing, but you have to know that farmers care for their animals. If we didn't give them the absolute best care possible, they wouldn't produce eggs for us.
Exactly.
So you see all of that for a variety and for choices. We give everybody choices on what they want to eat.
But I do think we speak with our vote with our dollar, and so the more we support our mm-hmm. local farmers, the organic free-range eggs, the more available they will be in time. That may affect the pricing as well.
And you know what? Some of our viewers had questions for you too.
My question to ask a dietitian is that when you eat eggs with or without a yolk, that the yolk is supposed to allow the absorption of the protein in egg white better. So people who say don't eat the yolk are missing out on the very essence of why you eat egg whites to make the protein go into your body. But they say you need the yolk to make it work. I don't know.
How often should I eat eggs?
How long are eggs considered fresh enough to eat before they're used only for baking?
Lots of good questions. Let's answer the first question from Dr. Cooperman. Why should we eat the yolk?
Well, the majority of people eat what we call mixed meals. So we're typically eating a plate of food, and where ideally half the plate is vegetables with the protein, egg being a fantastic source of protein, perhaps some whole grains on the plate as well. And the nutrients work together synergistically to enhance the absorption. If you just eat an egg white, you're going to absorb the nutrients from that egg white. If you just eat a yolk, the more mixed meals we eat though, nutritionally, nutritional science shows us that food works together to ultimately produce the best absorption of the nutrients.
Mm-hmm. Great information. Let's answer Evelyn's question. What about the time that a carton can stay in the fridge, and what about that expiry date?
Yeah, eggs actually have a really long shelf life on its own, but I always say to stick to what the guideline is. If there's a best before date, you should probably stick with that. But you'll notice that it's a very long expiration date for sure. Mm-hmm.
So all good tips, and thank you to our audience for the questions. And we're taking a short break. When we come back, we'll get cracking in the kitchen.
Still ahead on Carpe Diem.
There's honestly endless ways to eat them, and everyone has that favorite way. Scrambled, boiled, poached, definitely popular.
Carpe Diem. Seizing the day for Canadians as we age.
Welcome back. In this segment, we'll learn how to take eggs out for dinner. Patricia, eggs are not just for breakfast, are they?
Absolutely not. They fit in any time of the day. Breakfast, lunch, dinner, and even snacks.
There you go. Well, Patricia and I had a great time at that gorgeous Living Space kitchen. We're finally in the kitchen with Patricia. Hooray. This is my favorite thing to do, is learn about food. Let me ask you, what are the most popular ways to eat eggs?
There's honestly endless ways to eat them, and everyone has that favorite way. Scrambled, boiled, poached, definitely popular. Once you know these techniques, the sky's the limit on the number of recipes you can make with them.
You have to have the basics first, right?
Yeah, that's right. We're gonna basically scramble up an egg with some peppers and cheese in it that we're gonna roll up in a quick breakfast burrito. Just get the two eggs in there, and we're gonna use our sophisticated whisk again here, our fork, and you can add that milk as well.
So how much is this?
That's about 2 tablespoons with 2 eggs. You can use any kind of milk you want.
Or water if you chose.
Sure thing. Stir that up quite well. Once that is stirred up, you can add in the chopped green pepper. And then just to taste, you can put in a little bit of salt and pepper. And while you're doing that, I'm gonna step away and just get our stove going. With scrambled eggs, ideally you want your pan to be good and hot when you first put it in.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna give this a quick little mist with cooking oil spray just to reduce the stick-to-itiveness. And just pour the whole thing in.
Ooh.
You just turn it down to about medium-low, And then all you do with a scramble, just kind of lightly move it around.
Like fold it into itself.
That's right, till it starts forming soft curds. Give it a go. I know you got this.
Well, I'm so excited.
This is actually a really nice point, Carmen, to leave it on there and sprinkle on the cheese.
Oh.
Yeah, just sprinkle that on, spread it around a little bit, and let that melt away. So we can take it off, and we're just gonna put it into our whole wheat tortilla here. We'll put in a little bit of salsa. You roll, you tuck the ends in, and you roll some more. Voila, if we slice it, if you want to grab a plate, there you have it.
So scrambled, now I know better.
There you go.
Those recipes were so easy, and this is the perfect example of how you take eggs, throw in some veggies, and voila, you've got a fabulous meal.
That's
right. Not just for breakfast.
Yeah, a lot of people think that cooking for, especially if you're on your own, right, cooking for one can be, you know, not worth it or take too much time, but eggs are super quick, and eggs.ca has all kinds of recipes and ideas and how to be time efficient and all the rest of that good stuff.
Right, that's not all. We went back for more, so let's go back into that living space kitchen. I'm back in the kitchen with Patricia, which is really my favorite room in the house.
Mine too.
What's the next recipe?
Well, we're gonna move from breakfast onto lunch or even something you could have for a light dinner. So we're gonna saute a variety of mushrooms with some shallots and then toss it with leafy greens, yellow pepper, little Reggiano Parmesan, put a poached egg on top and drizzle with balsamic vinaigrette.
I love it. So how do you properly poach an egg?
We first of all want to get our water to a simmer. The key with poached eggs is to not only have your water simmering lightly before you start, but to use cold eggs.
That's
We're
right.
gonna crack our egg into a little saucer. The whole egg just goes in there, perfect. You wanna get the bowl nice and close to the water and then just slip it in there really gently. But you just leave it in there for about 4 minutes. The scooping out's important, right? So you don't destroy your masterpiece.
Beautiful. The perfect poached egg.
Turned out pretty good.
So what's next?
We are gonna reveal that secret of how to boil an egg. This pot already has some water in, so we'll just place the eggs. This water is cold or at room temperature. Turn your burner on to high, and you're gonna bring the water to a full rolling boil.
So then we need the egg timer. My
That's
favorite
right.
gadget.
Where's your app? Take it right off the heat.
Right off the heat.
Set it aside there. Set your timer for 12 minutes. Essentially, you know what's happening? They're cooking in the steam rather than in a vigorous boil. And so your egg is going to be more tender and delicate. Oh, there's our chickens.
Isn't that the funniest thing?
I love it, it's so good. So they're done.
They're done.
All right. So what I would do from here, Carmen, is I would drain the water, give them a good rinse in cold water, give them a little tap. The eggshell should peel off quite simply going from hot to cold like that.
And they can live in your fridge for about a week.
That's right, and you don't have to shell them before putting them in the fridge. The shell serves as a bit of a protection and keeps them nice and fresh.
Perfect. For these recipes and so many more information and tips and, of course, how-tos.
Eggs.ca is fantastic.
Bon appétit. Very simple tricks. How to boil an egg. I think I was doing it wrong for years. I think I always put it on.
There's really no right or wrong, eh?
So we are going to take our break. When we come back, we'll have our panel's final thoughts.
Still ahead on Carpe Diem.
That's a tough question. I think there had to be an egg first.
Egg.
Carpe Diem, seizing the day for Canadians as we age.
Welcome back. Before we wrap up this show, we wanted to have some fun and ask your opinion, which came first, the chicken or the egg?
That's a tough question. I'm gonna say egg.
I think there had to be an egg first.
Egg.
The chick.
The chick.
The chick.
What's the chick?
It's the cross between a chicken and an egg.
Being an OBGYN, I have to tell you,
The egg came first.
Patricia, what do you think?
Chicken or egg? I'm going to say both. It depends. It depends.
Ah, oh, that's a fun one. What do you think?
My vote's going for the chicken.
You're going for the chicken. Well, I think it was the chicken too. Final thoughts, Patricia?
I think regardless of what egg you choose, free range, white, brown, know that eggs are a good quality food, 14 key nutrients, good source of protein. Rest assured that all eggs in Canada for the past 40 years have been free of hormones and steroids, so don't be tricked by that advertising. They're quick, they're easy, they're good, they're endlessly versatile.
And your final thoughts?
Well, I think that it's important to know that probably 95-ish% of the farms in Canada are family owned. And that's even higher here in this province where it's 100%. Mm-hmm. So we're talking first, second, third generations. I hope to pass my farm on to my kids and let them continue on with this kind of a legacy. And know that we all love our animals and we love what we do. So we're trying to create the best product there is with a lot of care that goes into our lifestyle.
Well, it's great to meet someone that I've been supporting for years, which is my local farmer, so I appreciate it.
Well, thank you.
Absolutely. And I want to thank you, Patricia and Yushka, of course, for being with us today. And that's the show. And remember, as our CARP president, Moses Neimer, always says, the best way to keep going is to keep going. So, carpe diem and seize your day.